We've talked about some of the major races, the four glamour so-called races. Let's start checking in at some of these campaign headquarters. First, Ron Mizutani is at the governor's headquarters. Ron?
Good evening, Joe. We're live at Ward Warehouse where the entertainment has begun. And despite what polls say, the atmosphere here, the mood is very high, very ambitious, and very positive. Let's bring former Senator Randy Iwase, who joins us now. Senator Iwase, a longtime friend and also supporter of the governor. Senator, first of all, your thoughts as we head into this last week. I mean, before these hurricanes came about, there was a lot of focus on polls. But I want to talk about this week, first of all. The governor has had a very busy week. He's literally had to take off that campaign hat. And he did. Your thoughts?
Well, it has been a busy week, and the governor has, as you know, suspended his campaign activities so that he could deal with this very serious issue of his health.
You know, polls have been wrong in the past, and primary polls notoriously have been wrong in the past. What's the mood? What's your polls read, and how do you address that concern about making up ground of 18%?
Well, first of all, we're not 18% down. It's a very close race. Secondly, the polls were actually good for us because it inspired all of us, from the governor on down, to go out and support a candidate we truly believe in, a record we truly respect and believe in. And over the last few weeks, it's been a tremendous grassroots effort to get the message out, the governor's message out, and to let the people know that he has tremendous support behind him.
You know, he's had to make tough decisions, and he said that, knowing that he'd had to take this office, tough decisions would have to be made. And they were made. And he said, and some people agreed, others did not with his style or some of his decisions. Did that help him, hurt him, come for the second term?
Well, that's one of the things I respect most about Governor Abercrombie. He came in at a time when we were hit very badly economically. It did require tough decisions, whether it was contracts, a whole slew of matters. And he took them on. And he made the decisions that he had to make, some of which were unpopular, some of which the positive results will show after this election. But he laid the foundation for recovery then and a future forward.
It's a David and Goliath battle, truly. When you talk about money, you talk about money spent. And it could be history tonight if it comes out on the negative end for governor. This has been a memorable campaign, no doubt about it. And even governor said earlier this week, he's on a one-on-one conversation, it's been a very emotional campaign for him. Why do you see that? What he shared, it was he shared it was something about loving his family, loving his friends. But why do you think he said this was his most emotional campaign to date?
Well, it is his last campaign. After 40 years, over 40 years of service, Ron, from all levels of government, city, state, federal, working hard for the people, making tough decisions on behalf of the people. It's rough to be a I guess I can speak from personal experience. It's rough to be a politician running for office and being in office. It's very tough on the soul. But I know that for him, this was a very important campaign. He wants to finish the business that he started, to build upon the foundations that he laid. And I hope that the people will give him that chance. And from what we see, we believe that the people will give him that chance.
Randy, thanks for joining us. That first printout, maybe due in about 25 minutes, it'll reflect about 104 to maybe even up to 120,000 votes, a significant amount.
Yeah, the absentee voting, mail-in and walk-in, yes, it's gone up. And so we'll wait to see what the first printout is. But it is the first printout, and we'll see where we go from there.
Randy Iwase, former senator and also former candidate for governor, joining us live right here on KHON2. And he'll be joining us as soon as that first printout is released at that 7 o'clock hour. Again, the mood is still very positive here, despite these polls what the polls read, that the governor is trailing by 18%. Could he win a second term? We'll find out very soon right here in a very memorable historic night in Hawaii politics. Joe, back to you.